This is DS-87, Space Invaders Revolution, which is, it's Space Invaders. Oh, he got a zero. Here we go, here's the game. That wasn't the game, that was just a little loading screen, goof. Oh, yeah, you actually have to, insert coin. Oh, God, can you, like... Oh, wow, that's dumb. Let's look at the options, why don't we? Okay. Looking at the last video, the Madden one, I think there might be some audio desync. Like, audio desync is not a problem I've had for a very long time. Like, I've definitely never had that problem using OBS. It's especially a problem using, like, what was it? Using whatever capture thing I was using that would record at variable frame rates and then importing that into Premiere. And Premiere cannot support variable frame rates. That was a big pain. That was the last time I ever had audio desync issues. But if OBS is having audio desync issues, which, like, only materialize on 20-minute videos, well, that's not something very fun to try to troubleshoot. So I'll see if it happens in this video. If it does, I will look into it. I'm certainly recording at a much higher resolution, which I guess is kind of unnecessary, but it's fun. But anyway, let's get back to this video game. Let's play Space Invaders. I would like to play Space Invaders. Yep. That's exactly what this is. Yep. I have two fun stories about Space Invaders. One my mother says she tried playing Space Invaders as a kid. Oh, I blew up. I wasn't looking at the screen, I just immediately blew up again. But she says she was scared by the sound of them advancing. Which I found funny. Oh, I went to scratch my nose and I almost died again. That's no good. Oh, well, that one was entirely on me. I have no excuses for that one. And apparently I've heard the... In the original game, the fact that they got faster and the music got faster, like, that wasn't an intentional thing. It was just, you know, the game was rendering fewer sprites, so it ran faster. And they decided, hey, that's a fun gameplay thing. So they kept it in. So let's try New Age Space Invaders. What? This is a map of the world. Let's go to Italy. Let's go to the Leaning Tower of Pisa. Jesus, what? Ah, no, I don't want to use that camera. I don't know what screen they want me to look at here. Okay, top one. Wow. They had all that flair and, like, that 3D model of a spaceship, but now it's totally just Space Invaders with higher resolution. Like, barely even higher resolution, like, the DS screen is so low-res. It's just higher fidelity sprites, more colors, woo. Like, what? And, like, they even kept the sound effects, like, it's for nostalgia. And, like, this, that lame-looking explosion effect when they die, like... What? Oh, you can control it with the touchscreen, too. You can shoot through your own fences if you're into that sort of thing. On when you die, it's kind of nice. Like, what is this? And there's these buttons on the touchscreen that don't do anything. Presumably, I have to, like, unlock those or something. Like, what? What? I was expecting this to be, like, some modern bullet hell shoot 'em up. Shmup. Jeez, I can't talk. Like, some modern boot. Wow, I cannot talk or play video games, apparently. Jeez. I was expecting this to be some modern bullet hell shoot 'em up, like, and they're just calling Space Invaders, or maybe they stick Space Invaders sprites in there. I think that's what Space Invaders, like, Extreme might be? But this is just Space Invaders. Like, what? What is this, and why does it exist? Yeah, there's those buttons on the touchscreen, which presumably are some sort of power-up. What is this game, and why does it exist? It's just Space Invaders. Like, it's not really a game you need to re-release. I mean, I guess, sure. It's not really fun. Like, what? I'm having a great time playing Space Invaders on my DS. Like, can I do anything else? Why is there just this shoot button? Like, you can shoot by tapping the shoot button on the touchscreen. I don't think you can move using the touch. Well, I guess, no, of course you can. It's not multi-touch. Like, and none of these buttons, they're all deactivated, I guess. Like, can I pass this stupid game out for 10 minutes? I think this game has no reason to exist, as far as I'm concerned. Yeah, that's... Wow, this video's not 10 minutes yet. I guess since I already accidentally showed it, I might as well introduce my new camera system, since I've been messing around with the streaming setup. Yeah, not a streaming setup, this recording setup, since it's been so long since I did any of these videos. I've spent a while messing around with the microphone, and it still barely sounds any better because I'm too lazy to get a proper microphone setup. And like the video layout, I made the two like screens on top of each other bigger, so like when I forget to change what screen it's focused on, you can still actually see what's on the correct screen. It looks nicer, and it's recording at 1440p now, which is kind of unnecessary. It might be the source of that audio desync I encountered, but you know, with hardware encoding, it's still using like 20% of the CPU for 1440p60. You know, it means these squares are slightly more square than they were before, I guess. I don't know. But the new thing I was playing around with, the camera, I figured since, well, the DS has dual screens, obviously I should have dual camera set up. Like, duh. No, actually, it's like I was setting up this webcam like I had before, and I was thinking, you know, I probably have a better camera than this stupid old webcam. And I remembered, oh yeah, I have that Handycam that like I used for PAX videos and stuff. It's been sitting in somewhere. So I went through all the effort to dig up the webcam, the camcorder, the camera's charger, the camera, a tripod, the component out cables for the camera, and the component adapter for my capture card. I was like, okay, I've got all this set up, I've got these cameras mounted absurdly high since I have these absurdly high tripods. Does it look any better than my webcam? I guess slightly. Like, it's got better auto exposure. So like if I have my monitor white, like if the game is white, then the webcam gets totally washed out unless I go into the settings and manually set the exposure and stuff, whereas the camcorder handles that nicer, but it's higher frame rate! Woo! I guess that's the big change. So I went through all that effort and I just put the two cameras on top of each other. But the cool thing this camcorder does that the webcam certainly cannot do is it's got 42x optical zoom, which is real nice in PAX when you're sitting in the back of a room and you're trying to record someone in the front of the room. Without a tripod, obviously. I don't know if anyone ever actually watched my PAX videos. They're barely worth watching. let's turn this game down. But what I can also use that for is showing my my poor DS here. It's been so long since the last video, and this DS has seen better days. So let me go. This camera is literally, it's mounted so high, it's literally out of reach. Like, the webcam's right here, that camcorder. If I try to reach it, I actually can't reach it. Maybe if I stretch a little bit, I actually can't reach it from here. So I'm gonna go stand up and zoom. I'm gonna do some zooming. This is real professional here. I actually rehearsed this, but I forgot all these cables that have tangled literally everywhere. So let's take this camera and zoom! All the way in. So yeah, you can now see features of my body at unreasonably close up. Yeah, look at those stripes. So let's take a look at this DS. So when I bought this DS secondhand, because I had an original DS once upon a time, but I sold that when I got a DS Lite. So then when I was like, yeah, I should get a capture card so I can make DS videos, I had to go out and buy an original DS again. And when I got this thing, it was in pristine condition, which is kind of impressive for such an old thing, buying it used. You know, I installed the capture card mod. You can barely even tell that I did a kind of crappy job drilling out the hole for the USB port, because it's completely covered up by the USB cable. Haha, take that. You're technically supposed to, like, put some, because you can't use this stylus port anymore. Like, there's a thing in the way now. So you're technically kind of supposed to glue that up so dust doesn't get in, but I didn't. But it was in perfect condition for the longest time, and we used it not just for those DS videos, but for, like, playing a couple DS games on the TV, like what are they called? Professor Layton games. And, like, my original DS, it was a beast. Like, that thing fell down a flight of stairs once, and the Game Shark that was in the GBA slot broke, but the DS itself was perfectly fine. This thing has, for the most part, just been sitting on a table. But one day I look at it, and I discover, look at that. That poor hinge has broken pretty much completely there. The other side of it's, well, it was fine, but that... that hinge is completely yeah, look at that. So I'd heard stories online about people's DS hinges breaking, but it never actually happened to me. I was like, yeah, what are you doing to your poor game systems that their hinges break? This one is just basically just sitting on a table, and the hinge, I don't know what happened. So I felt bad about that, but then, wouldn't you know, not too long after, it fell off a table, and actually... someone was there for it that time, so we actually know where it came from. But it suddenly got all of these cracks. You can see this big crack along the back that's had a piece of tape put over it, which I don't know if that's actually helping much. And then that continues around to not that side, but this side. Yeah, it's mirrored in my preview window, which is weird. Well, it's not mirrored, which is what makes it weird. Yeah, so there's a lot of tape put over there, and yeah, you saw where that other... so, like, that hinge is completely broken off, but then where the other hinge goes, like... it's not doing too great either. Yeah, look at that. That is no good. And, this corner here has gotten just completely chipped off. So yeah, this poor DS was in perfect condition. I don't think it got mistreated much more than a DS usually does. Oh, yeah, see, when I close the screens, my monitor goes white, and then my webcam struggles. Yes. You shouldn't be able to do that. It worries me. that this thing is just going to completely fall apart, and I'm going to have to get a new DS and install a new capture card. Like, it just worries me every time I open the hinge. But yeah, that's really interesting. Like, people always talk about how Nintendo systems are so strong, except the original DS. And I was like, oh, my original DS is great. It's like my DSIs. Those are probably the ones that have had the most issues. But yeah, what do you know? This thing is falling apart, which is troubling for sure. But hopefully it can hold out. I've still got a lot more DS videos to record. See you next time, maybe with just one webcam.